start off with Gayatri Mantra. Gayatri Mantra is a prayer for good intellect, good Buddhi Shakti. May all of us have an illumined mind. That's the message of Gayatri Mantra. Om Bhurbhuvasvaha.
Om Bhurbhuvasvaha.
Tat Savitur Vareeniyam.
Tat Savitur Vareeniyam.
Bhargo Devasya
Dhimahi. Bhargo Devasya
Dhimahi. Dhiyo Yona Prachodayat.
Dhiyo Yona Prachodayat.
Shubhodaya. Couple of days back, One person, she rang me and said, what is the purpose of yoga? We spend so much of time on the physical wellness, but the purpose of yoga is to connect our soul to the highest. And aren't we wasting our time? We should be doing meditation and connect ourselves. And her interpretation of yoga was that one. And there are two dimensions. One school of thought, they say that body is going to perish sooner or later. It's your time to connect yourself to the highest. Spend on Vedanta. They talk on the mind, mind and beyond. Body is not important. Another school of yoga, they think physical fitness is the ultimate and you need not have to look after the mind. Mind and beyond, connecting the mind to the Supreme, it is not required. But yoga is a synthesis of both. You need both the illumined mind and physical, good body, healthy body. If the body is not there, you can't do any practice. Sharira madhyam khalu dharma sadhanam. You need a healthy body, able body, fit body. Then only you can do in the whatever you have to do in the material world and also in the spiritual world, you need a healthy body. This body is made up of this, our personality has various layers. The one is the gross body, is called as Annamaya Kosha. Annamaya, Anna means the food. This body is survived, sustained through the food we eat, and also Anna means the food we eat, ultimately it consumes this body also. We eat and that food itself consumes this body. Various ailments come to the body because of the food. Initially we eat the food and finally the food eats us and the body goes back into the nature, into the earth element and water element. This physical body, gross body, is made up of earth element and water element. It gives the support to this body. This body is sustained through the earth and water element. And beyond that one, we are breathing. When you are breathing, there is a fire element. The breathing brings in the temperature to the body. The body warmth, fire element, air element. And to breathe, we need the space. The pranamaya kosha, through pranamaya kosha, air element and fire element and space, ether, it's made up of these three parts. And beyond that one, our mind has various faculties. One is mana, buddhi, ahankara, chitta and chetana. It's a five components. And mana means indecisive mind. And the children, generally, a small child, if you take the child to a lolly shop, ask the child to pick up a lolly, child is confused whether to take green lolly, yellow lolly, red lolly. It cannot make a decision. Not only the child, we grown up also, we don't know what we need in our life. And we start for 2 years, we give up, we take up on another project, we give up. And at the end of the life has passed and nothing has achieved. Many people, about 10 years back, one person said he wants to learn and teach yoga. And that was the statement 10 years back. And last week again he said he wants to learn yoga and teach. And only in the conceptual stage, think, and we don't entertain that one. Mind is an indecisive mind. And the mind, mana, buddhi. Buddhi says do or not to do. And ahankara, ego is required. Without ego, we can't function. I want to learn. I want to go. I want to sleep. I want to work. Without I cannot function. That ego has to be in balance. If too much of ego, it may ruin our growth. And too less ego, we may not have any motivation. And chitta is the memory shell. And beyond that one, chetana, extension of memory. When the memory is awakened, full memory, you remember the past also. And future direction you can see. It's a chetana. And the mind, in the second sutra, Patanjali Yoga Sutra, he says, Chitta Vritti Nirodhaha. The mind, you elevate your mind to the Nirodha state. The mind, it's a Patanjali, according to the Patanjali, mind has five components. One is a mooda mind, lazy mind, lethargy mind. I have no motivation to do anything. There is no motivation for me. And given a chance, a cold day, I want to be in bed. I cannot be motivated. I want to be, under the blanket is much more comfortable. I have no motivation to progress in my life. That is the mooda mind. Second one is called as kshipta mind. Kshipta mind, it's only selfish motive. What is in for me? If there is something for me, then only I will do. If there is no reward for me, monetary or something, if it is not there, I won't do. It's a rajasic mind, highly selfish mind. What is for me and my family? I don't want to do anything beyond. If there is no benefit, I won't do. Then third one is called as vikshipta mind. Vikshipta mind, starts wanting to progress, but it doesn't have enough motivation, enough energy. It knows that selfish life itself is not ultimate, but beyond that one we had to progress. But there is not enough motivation, energy drive within. That is called as vikshipta mind. I want to do, but it's underestimate my potential. Why take risk? So much of trouble is there, so much of responsibility. Why take unnecessary problem? Vikshipta mind. And another one is ekagra mind. Person starts getting a concentration. There is a higher to this material life. I want to do something higher. I have seen enough of material life, but I'm not getting enough satisfaction. I want to progress. There is something beyond this one. But that person starts looking up for something higher. Higher and progress, but still enough drive is not there. Initially it is tamasic mind, then rajasic mind. In the ekagra, that sattvic comes, but not that intense. But nirodha mind, the mind is set on the goal, set on the ideal. It knows the purpose of the life, that he or she realizes the purpose of life. It is not the mundane existence. It is not for living for myself. This life has to be of use for others. And I should achieve something great in my life. Life is very precious. And life cannot be this. It's a limited shelf life. I have to stride great. I should make a great inroad in my life. I should achieve great things in my life. That ekagra, nirodha mind. Initially started off with lazy mind, selfish mind, and without motivation, starting to look something higher and further progress, and fully focused, nirodha mind. Patanjali says, the elevate your mind, come out, wake up from your slumberness, and shake off your selfish motive, and work towards the higher ideals in your life and accomplish the great things. And it says that any great leader, if you want to be a great inspirer, great leader, your mind has to go to Nirodha. If your mind is not set on Nirodha, you cannot motivate others, you cannot motivate yourself, and you can't inspire others, you can't inspire your children, you can't inspire others. If you want to be a great leader, great motivator, great inspirer, and if you want to achieve great things in your life, elevate your mind, purify the mind, sattvic mind, and contemplate and set your mind, set your goal on the highest things. Then the inner unfoldment happens. That is the path of emancipation, path of liberation, as mentioned in the scriptures. In the yoga, yoga says you have to use this body and it's a filter your mind, calm your mind, and it's elevate your mind, elevate the mind to the such an extent that it's the no point of return. You are always inspired, and that's the purpose of yoga, is that one. Lie down on your back.